Okay, just to be clear, this build gives up virtually every opportunity to have anything that resembles defense in the pursuit of just more damage. I'm going to be rolling Bladed Rounds, Blighted Turret, and Cold Snap. Cold Snap acts as our stopgap measure when we get rushed. Bladed Turret helps spread our toxic and vulnerability, as well as acts as a bit of a way to keep the enemies occupied somewhere else that's not on top of us. Blighted Rounds is our bread and butter, core to our damage. It switches all of our damage over to attacking resistance, which isn't as strong as armor to start with, and ramps up our damage. The splash effect is a nice bonus too, applying toxic to a bunch of guys that then suddenly now have vulnerability as well. There are a few nodes you could trade off here, but for the most part, the skill tree is kind of set in stone. You could swap out the 10% increased damage to enemies afflicted by toxic to effectively remove the minimum range on your long-range damage stat. Or you could swap the weapon leech node here for a cooldown on bladed skills, but you really won't be needing the cooldown reduction for your blight skills. If all goes well, your bladed rounds will basically never go down, and your bladed turret already has a really short cooldown. And if you're curious about the 2-point dip into the demolisher part of the tree, that's almost entirely for the increased resistance piercing. My preferred weapon for this build is the legendary bolt-action rifle, the Iceberg. The AoE freeze effect is what you're after on it, and it really helps keep the enemies under control and allows you to just pick them off in sequence when you get a good headshot. As for the shatter effect that it has, you could probably swap that out for something else that better fits how you're playing or whatever you like. Given the cooldown, it can't really be heavily abused. For mods on armor, Icicle Storm for a cascading splash damage from killing enemies you froze with Cold Snap is awesome, and Long Winter to increase the range really helps you hit a lot more of the field with Cold Snap. You'll likely need both Toxic Lead and Trick Up the Sleeve to maintain your ammo. If you find you can drop one or the other, feel free to do so. After that, it's just about boosting your weapon attacks as much as you possibly can. Feel free to use whatever combination works best for you. Here's the ones I'm using. For your stats, you're looking to have firepower and long-range damage on every piece of gear. After that, you're going to want between 60 to 90% total status power to be sure your freezes are lasting long enough so that you can take advantage of them. And cooldown reduction from there, until you feel your cold snaps coming up fast enough to be reliable for defense. After that, do whatever you want, really. Now that I've covered the build itself, I'm going to leave you with some footage of me actually running this build so you can get a feel for how I actually play it.
We've been detecting massive energy spikes in insurgent territory near the old chemical plant. The last thing I can afford is those monsters generating more power. I need you to disable their operation. Push your way through the slums, reach that chemical plant, and terminate any bastard you find.
Damn it. More of them. Shira, there's an elevator in this lab.
Yeah, that matches our blueprints for the plant. The elevator should lead to the heart of the facility.
All I'm missing is some elevator music. Whatever that thing is, that switch is leaving.
Whoa.
Shira, about those energy spikes? The insurgents had a functioning power cell down here.
What did you do with it?
It's disabled. I'll see if Zahidi can take a look at it. And I found a pod down here.
You saved some lives today, Outrider. I would expect nothing less from you.